granted of a weak chin, but of a very powerful nose.
You know, that's what people recognize me from, that stuff.
There's a risk
to say, okay, I'm going to give up what's worked. I'm not going to do, you know, weak chin jokes.
You got plenty of material. You don't need that chin stuff anymore.
This is going to push him a lot to maybe transcend a type of comedy that maybe portrayed his looks and only his looks, because I don't think that's what his comedy is about at all.
What would it mean to me to have an extreme makeover? It would change almost everything in my life.
Okay, that's stand-up comic Steve-Mittleman. Before we see how he looks now, take a look at the procedures he's gone through just a few months ago.
First, he gets a leading man's chin.
If his comedy career is going to be dependent on a bad chin, we're going to probably try to ruin it today.
And lipo sculpts his jawline.
It's always a challenge to get to make the contours really nice, but he looks great.
Then he gets lifts to his cheeks, neck, and upper eyelids.
I think it's going to make his eyes look more open and less tired. But working on this neck was no joke.
And finally, his nose is resculpted. Later, LASIK surgeon Dr. Maloney gives him eagle vision. Dr. Shamban smooths his complexion. And Dr. Donia sparkles his smile.
And he's here with us in the studio, comedian Steve-Mittleman.
Hi, very nice to be here. Amazing.
Is that unbelievable? And you guys do all this in 6 weeks, right?
Six weeks.
That's quite a challenge.
Yes.
Very much of a challenge.
Were you nervous, Steve?
Well, actually, what made it a lot easier was the fact that the top-notch doctors that are on the show. The reason I chose to do the show was watching the show and seeing how great everybody was.
But didn't it ruin your act?
I'm not funny anymore. But I'm so good looking now. I'm dating Katie Holmes and I hate psychiatry.
Did you have an eye problem?
I had a tremendous, if I was looking at one camera, the other camera would go, you're looking over here? I mean, I had strabismus surgery. The day I got there, the next morning, it was like a 2-3 hour surgery and my eyes were straightened for the first time in my life. If you saw my baby pictures, one eye's going that way, one eye's going that way, and...
Well, that's different from cross-eyedness.
Well, I'm a wandering eye. I'm a wandering Jew with a wandering eye.
Now, I know, Dr. Dorfman, you did not do his dentistry, but you pioneered some of the things done for him.
Right, well, Dr. Donia did his teeth. Again, he whitened his teeth. We got them as white as we could, and then we did 9 veneers, 4 uppers and 5 lowers. Great smile.
It's funny, as I left the doctor's office, Dr. Donia's office, with 9 beautiful Da Vinci veneers, they go, try not to chew at them.
just a joke. Yeah,
who did the surgery?
Oh, Dr. Fisher.
What problems did he present?
Well, he's such a comic, you know, I couldn't get him to, you know, be quiet and let me put him on the table. But I had to remove some of the muscles in his neck and some really deep tissue contouring. We did a lot of work underneath there. I tried to ruin his career.
I had the upper chin handle, like the love handle went up, you know. It's all carbs.
What's it like when you're working it? It's an artistry?
You know, it's you in your own zone, your own world, probably like you're doing, and it's just fun. It's enjoyable to see the contours change, and you're in control of that, and knowing it's going to make a big difference.
How did you work with him, Sam?
Well, I ended up trying to give Steve a new look for his act. Steve is a comedian, he's a funny guy, but now he looks so handsome, he looks like a newscaster. So we wanted to give him a great look. We gave him a suit that had some color and some playfulness to it, but was still sophisticated. So we took a little of the comedian, a little of the new dashing, handsome man he is now.
What did it do for you, Steve, really?
Absolutely nothing. Well, no, I'm just funny. I'm watching the tape over here on the screen. Listen, I have a beautiful girlfriend now. Yeah, that's wonderful.
Didn't have that before.
No, I didn't have that before. And but the career's going well. I have a book I'm working on called, it's a comedy diet book. I've been writing, in fact, I wrote a lot of it during my extreme makeover time. And it's called 1,000 Points of Lightness. Volume 1 is 200 points. And it's a comedic approach to losing weight. It's about lightening up to lighten up.
How do they do it in 6 weeks, Dr. Griffin?
Well, it's really a team approach. We have to very carefully plan the surgery. We have to coordinate with other, like the dentist, like Dr. Dorfman, and actually Michael Thurman's a big part of this, losing weight and getting fit.
Have you ever started on anyone and said we couldn't do it? Well, that would have been a riot.
The worst fear is that the show's canceled in the middle of your procedure. You're like, I'm sorry, but we did a nostril and we got a dimple and you got a cleft.
Someone will lean over and say, that's showbiz.
That's showbiz.
Were you worried at all about having them do that to your face? I mean, a little scared?
Well, basically, I'm disconnected, so it's okay. Was I worried? It was a big for a comedian.
You know you're going to get bruised, right? You're going to have some pain.
Listen, I never took Vicodin in my life, but I'll tell you, you mentioned Vicodin to people that love Vicodin, it's like, you have leftovers? You have some Vicodin? You know, Vicodin and sleeping pills the first week, you know, it's people say, did it hurt? There's a lot of anesthesia going on. I was probably in reality TV history the person closest to where the production took place. I lived 3 to 4 miles away from the makeover mansion.
The
makeover mansion, yeah. And had I, it was 9.5 weeks my process, and had not been under anesthesia for 9 of them, it would have been very tough.
Congratulations,
I appreciate
Steve.
It a lot.
Steve-Mittleman, what a story. We'll be right back.